Okay, so today we are going to learn about the shaper head tool assembly. This is how shaper tool assembly works, how to assemble it. You can see the exploded view of shaper tool. Start a new file. As you can see, I am selecting the mouse controls. You can go here in the toolbar section, right click and say customize. You can see your mouse gestures. So in the part environment, you can see I have done so many settings, and in the sketch environment so many settings have that you can select here. SKETC switch or center line. So I'll just drag it and put it in the sketch environment where exactly I require. So I'll put it here and say okay. So now I go to sketch environment. I am in sketch environment. So drag, right click and drag it. So I'll get this mouse gestures. Select the center line and select the line. So drag it and put it in the place. Draw the line, draw it somewhere exactly below the origin. Right click and select midpoint and select the origin and make it coincident. So now you get this line as a center midpoint connected to the origin. You'll get asymmetric type of drawing where you can draw and then you can mirror also. Drawing approximately, or I can drag it and select all this and mirror it. select inside this box and select the line. It is mirror, and as you can see, it is not joined. So drag it and put it here. I'll try to give the dimensions here. As you can see, dimension of this line is 70, and total dia of the circle is 155. And the height is 42. And height of this is 21. And this is 1. Angle is 65. And I have to draw another rectangle here. Select these two lines and select the center line and make it symmetric. Smart dimension is, okay, it is given from the bottom. You can draw from this to this. It is 64 and this is 100. So these 2 points, I'll make it as 100 as well. Circle of they are 16 and make this as, so I'll make it dimension as radius 20, and this I'll make it as symmetrical, concentric. Okay, the height of this is 11.
As it is, without making it as a construction line, I can exit the sketch. Now I got exactly the drawing of back plate. Only one by one I can. Accordingly, select the line and select these two and I can select 155 to make it as 155. Okay. Now, which is hidden on the sketch. The center line I can say V1 you can see here I have to yeah. Select this and edit feature, and I would like to select even this portion also for extrusion. I'd like to select all entire area. For extrusion, except the hole. As you can see here. So, I'll make it as extrude cut. And select the center line. I'd like to select the center line first and then extrude. So it will select the respective sketch. Select the outside. And select the offset of 155 divided by 2. Yeah, as you can see, it is 38 from the center. Total 77.5 minus 38 will be 39.5. So I'll select 39.5 as a cut of this area also. Can you see that? So now the cut on other side also can be done in the same way. Extrude cut, select the sketch and select the area which you want to cut. Offset it, say 155 divided by 2, 77 other side. Direction is this side, and this again I can make it as 37.5. As you can see, the cut section, I can select this place and select the sketch and draw the circle of uh, 155 dia. Yes, 155. So select this sketch and say extrude cut. I want to cut outer part, so I'll select flip side. As you can see, direction arrow direction is pointing towards outside. Okay, I want to cut here and I want to make a hole. Of 22 should cut throughout. I want to make a cut off. So I can select the top plane and sketch it and make it normal and draw the circle of 45. Yeah. And cut it, extrude cut up to 42. You can see here how it is done. Off the sketch, control 1 is this view. As you can see in the hidden lines visible, control 5, control 6 is bottom view, and if I want to view the section view, here you go, the section view. As you can see here, I want to match this view into this view. I want to change the sketch plane. Actually, this I have drawn on sketch front plane. So this sketch I will shift it to top plane so that I can get this view. Select sketch and edit sketch plane and select the top plane. Again, as you can see here, the view of the back plate is completely changed Control 1. Oh, okay. There's some problem here. Okay, I need to change the position of this sketch into the front plane. And cut it in the opposite direction. Now I get a view. Perfect view of backlit, elevation and section view, as you can see here. The view is matching with the 2D drawings. Control 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So this is the back plate, and we shall go for the second item, vertical slide. Okay, let's go for new file, control N, select the part. Actually, I have created a template here for my drawings. Select that template and say okay. Front plane. So I'll try to draw the drawing of the top view as it is in the top view plane so that I can get this view. This as elevation, this as a side view or section view, and this as a top view. So select top view plane or top plane and select the sketch. We'll go for line. Draw a line. Right click and select it. Select the midpoint and hold the control button and select the origin and say make coincident. Now I get a line equal with the origin. Draw a center line. Draw this line. So as I can see here, this is a symmetrical view. So what I can do is I can select all these drawings and go for mirror. Click in the mirror about and select this line and say okay. So I can join this, drag and join. Circle is 16 dia, 16, radius 15, this is radius 15, and this as 100. Total is 45. And this has 20. This is 36 as given. And this as 70. So I can see the arc here. From this point to this point, and the point is vertically coincident with the origin line, and the radius of the arc is 100. As I can see here, the radius is given as 41. Hold shift and select the path. 41. Okay, this 41 is from the hold control and hold shift select. So friends, now I got these dimensions. As you can see here, completely matching with the 2D drawing of top view. I'll exit the sketch through my mouse gestures where I can make it a process easy. Okay. Try to extrude this, extrude, select the center line, and actually I want to extrude only this part. Then what I can do is actually you can see here this part, the lines are given as as you can see here, this line is given. I would like to draw that line also, where that line is, the dimension is given as 1.5. So here you can see the dimension. This 1.5, there is a gap between the section. Throughout this, you can see here is a gap here for clearance. Make it as 1.5. Okay, exit the sketch and extrude, select the center line and select only these parts, offset and the dimension as given. You can see here dimension as 25. So make it as 25. Sketch is hidden, show sketch. So extrude, select this line and select this section and this section. Extrude up to 240. So 40. Okay. And this part select the front plane. As you can see here, select the front plane and draw the sketch. So this is trim this one part and center line. Draw the two circles or holes. This is 16 through, and this has 20 through. The radius of this is 115. This and this will be concentric. And the radius of this arc is 123. So make this as vertical and this is concentric. This and this will be tangent. The height of the these two are 58. Now the sketch is constrained. You can see all the dimensions are matching. Okay. Let's say extrude boss or base. Reverse direction. Select up to next. Okay. So now you can see sketch is done. And bottom part I need to extrude cut it. So what I can do is go in sketch and edit the sketch and draw the lines connecting to that sketch. Exit. So it show the problem using the sketch, check sketch for feature. Okay. Say okay. Exit the sketch and rebuild anyway. So boss or base, edit. I select only this part and this part. Okay. And cut the remaining part. Your sketch. Extrude cut. Select sketch, respective sketch, and select this. Contours. Select through all. Okay. Hide the sketch. So you can see the. So now I can select. Now I got a perfect part according to the 2D drawings. You can see here still atomic. Few modifications, select this part and go for sketch. Select this and go for sketch. Select this surface. select this part and go for sketch. Make this as normal and this as so. Just what I did is converting entities, convert entities. Select the sketch and select this surface for sketch. As you can see here, I can go for sketch and then select this surface and select these two as convert entities. Isometric, you can see here the two circles are converted into entities. So features, extrude cut, through all. Or I can select the blind and select say 100. Selected contours. Say okay. Intended cut does not intersect the model. Okay. Okay. Now the hole is through and through. Section it. You can see here the exact matching with 2D drawing. Control 1, Control 5 is stop you. So this is a vertical slide. And next we go to swivel plate. Swivel plate. I'll go for new file. Select front plane and select the sketch. Draw the circle of 30 dia. And draw the rectangle. This radius is 115 and as you can see this is tangent, so I'll remove the tangent relationship. This is is 100, as you can see. This is 100. This and this and this, I'll make it as symmetric. This and this, make it vertical. Even this and this, make it vertical and draw the arc. Of radius, once again 115, and as you can see, this is concentric with this circle, and so what I can do, I can draw the plot like this, center point arc slot, and click, first click here, second click, third click, and fourth click. So this point always coincides with the center line. And the radius is 8. This is 56. The radius of this is 88. And once again, this arc radius is coincident with the circle, concentric with the circle. And this radius I can give as 115, and concentric with this. Coincident with this point. Now you can see the dimension here is 90. Shift and select the arc and select the line 90, and the line is okay, the dimension is given as 66. This I'll mirror it. I get this is 22. Extrude this part. back as 20. Sketch show and extrude the front part as 31. Even I want to extrude this part also. Okay, now extrude cut, select the same line, extrude cut, contours, select this and this, okay, so the deep is 6 mm as given. I can see the section is matching with the part. Select this, go for sketch, select the circle and 15. From here to here it is 14 and circle dia is 14. Extrude cut only up to 2. As you can see, the pin is taper. We'll make the circle of dia 12. And cut the other side. As you can see here, the figure is almost done. Now you can move on to the assembly part. Go for new and select assembly, or I can select movies and select assembly. So here I can see here, I want to browse it and select the backplate. So here you can see the backplate is attached to my cursor. I'll go and say okay. You can see this is very important step in creating the assembly base. always select the OK tick. I'll show you once again. I'll repeat it. Delete this part. Rebuild. I can see here. Insert components. Browse and select the backplate and say OK. Always say OK here. Always. I'll tell you why. After saying OK, off this sketch visibility. Here you can see the front plane, top plane, right plane of back plate and front plane, top plane, right plane assembly. So it's always matches front plane and top plane and right plane to right plane. So here you can see it is showing F. It is showing F here, which means it is fixed. It is not moving. So if I say move component, not moving. It's showing the selected component is fixed. It cannot be moved. But for view visibility, I can rotate and see. But actual component is fixed in all degree of angle. So the insert component, browse and select the vertical slide. So vertical slide, as you can see here, is not fixed. Here it is showing minus sign. That means it is not fixed. So I'll match this and this as concentric. So now it moves in this direction. This and this say parallel. So okay, so insert component, select browse, select swivel plate, match, match these two holes. And these two surfaces are coincident. Insert component. Browse and select the washer. Rotate. Insert components, browse and select the clamping screw. I can select this and this as concentric. And also this and this as concentric. Okay. The washer is small washer. Insert component, browse. Insert component, browse. Small washer. Select these two circles. Okay. These two surfaces is coinciding with each other. And these two surfaces are coinciding. Insert, browse, and select this drill pin. These two surfaces are concentric. And this surface will coincide with surface. Okay. Now select drag plate. Pivot pin, select the front plane of the right plane of this swivel plate and this this and this is concentric. So I can fix this for temporarily and make this assembly. Fix this also. This and this part is fixed. Incident and the washer. insert, tool fixing screw, and load this. Insert the bar, and rotate this. In this direction. Select this tool and make it as concentric. This part and this part is coincident. And insert, browse, space, select these two parts. Insert, browse, handle, vector, insert, insert, browse, and nut. Select these two surfaces and make it concentric. I can select all this and also the screw bar. I'll make it as this, and this. I can turn it, so this one is slot mid, select the slot and select this slot and select the so here you can see here slot movement and also the vertical slide and tool holder. This completes the shaper tool part and assembly. Thank you.